Welcome back to Proactive. You're watching the lunchtime wrap for Wednesday, the 9th of November. Well, the ASX enjoyed another morning in the green today, marking the third straight day of gains down under. The materials sector propped up the win this morning, with iron ore, gold and lithium stocks among the best performers come midday. Now, the benchmark index is up 0.71% at noon, breaking past that 7,000 point barrier, while the All Ords is trading 0.6% higher. And with the midterm elections in full swing, investors took Wall Street through another positive session overnight. The S&P 500 and the Nasdaq notched a 0.6% gain, while the Dow finished up 1%. Looking over at commodities now, oil prices are on the fritz as China's rising COVID cases and supply risks curb investor appetite. Gold gave up its gains this morning to fetch $1,713 an ounce, while iron ore futures jumped 2.3%. And digital gold is in the red today after crypto exchange Binance announced it would bail out rival FTX trading. Bitcoin dropped as much as 14% today, while Ethereum was trading 16% lower earlier. Checking in with today's top stories, criminals have published Medibank customer data on the dark web. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese said today that the recent data breaches represent a huge wake-up call for corporate Australia. Now over at the top end of town, Big Four bank NAB delivered an 8.3% lift in cash earnings, but it did drop 1.8% following its full-year report. And among the small caps, Alicanto Minerals is up 36% after it bought the Falun copper, gold and zinc mine in Sweden. Mika Metals also jumped 1.8% after it discovered a new gold lode, and Brookside Energy rose 8.3% thanks to a new drill program at the Juanita oil and gas well. Now, to see all of those stories and more, you can visit our website, proactive.com.au. Until then, I'll be back with more market news for you tomorrow, just after midday. Have a great afternoon.